Cotello with your Pinpoint Weather 12 forecast.
But it's a good day to take a little walk or bike ride with the kids. Head to one of the ceremonies happening today to honor our veterans as we take a look at our conditions outside here, Newport. We've got clear skies heading over the bridge. We will start to see some high clouds streaming in. Still lots of clear conditions up in North Scituate. Not many tree leaves left on the trees here, at least from this view. But that is one of the issues here with this next storm coming in tonight. Another round of heavy rain that, with leaves clogging the storm drains, could lead to some street flooding during tomorrow morning's commute. North Kingstown, you're dry as well. We're in the upper 40s. Providence, Smithfield, New Bedford's at 47. Newport coming in right now around 46, just below 50 in Westerly. And we'll see those temperatures climb another degree or two before the day is over. Our live Doppler radar this noontime showing those dry conditions, and we'll keep it in the green for our threat tracker through the rest of the day today. Tuesday, we got some heavy rain, mainly in the morning through midday hours. Some strong wind gusts, keeping an eye on rivers and streams. At this point, we're not expecting significant river flooding or even in some spots minor river flooding, but we'll see those river water levels still rising up and in some locations maybe overspilling their banks just a bit. Wednesday, threat tracker staying elevated. It's dry and it's very chilly, but we could see some strong wind gusts on Wednesday. We're going to talk all about that. Weather alert right now, the only spot that we have any sort of alert or advisory is for high winds over Nantucket. That starts tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. and goes until 4 in the afternoon. We've got high pressure keeping us dry through the rest of the day today. Notice the clouds advancing in from the southwest, so those will start to stream in by the end of the day today. Here's the center of our low pressure rain well out ahead of it in our approaching cold front, and so we'll see the dry skies through the evening hours, giving way to some rainfall after midnight tonight. Rain will be heavy at times tomorrow morning during the commute. Then this area of low pressure rides right up and near our coastline during the day tomorrow. And that's going to give us that heavy rain in the first half of the day, but it's a fast mover again. So here we are at 1:30. Most of the rain already exited, and we're dry for the evening hours of your Tuesday. So sort of a short fused event here where we get a moderate to heavy rainfall, another inch and a half of rain on the way for us. And that'll lead to some slow travel and the potential for that minor flooding. So here's those leaf clogged storm drains we're concerned about for tomorrow morning's drive into work. And as we look at the winds, they're going to be strongest right around the late morning and midday hours as that low passes very close to us. So on the area where we're under that high wind watch, Nantucket, 45 to 55 mile per hour gusts. Along the Rhode Island coastline, could see some gusts 35 to 45 miles per hour. And further inland, the winds are a little lighter. We may actually get our strongest winds on Wednesday behind the storm. And boy, it's going to be really chilly when those winds are blowing too. We'll see wind chills in the 20s on Wednesday afternoon. So enjoy this afternoon's light winds, just an increase in the clouds to finish out the day. The night, not going to be nearly as cold. We'll fall to around 40, dry early in the night with that rain moving in late. And then notice the probability of rain tomorrow, showcasing that first half of the day is when that rain going to be moving through. In our 7-day forecast, we're talking two rounds of moderate to heavy rainfall. So Tuesday, dry and chilly, Wednesday, Thursday, and then late Thursday into Friday, we'll have another chance for about an inch of rain or so. One thing we'll have to watch for, whether it'll be cold enough for a brief wintry mix well inland Thursday night before changing over to rain. It's getting to be that time of year as we track more and more of these systems. Brian, we'll have to keep you on the lookout for that. You want to check out Tony's latest forecast tonight?